Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we're gonna discuss about term lookup transformation. So what is term lookup transformation and when we can use it? So before going forward, if you haven't watched last video of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video. So let's start with term lookup. So it is used to analyze the set of text records. Next is, it looks the set of predefined nouns and phrases in the input text column that should be our OLEDB source and provide count of occurrence as an output on row by row basis. It will accept only Unicode string, that is DT underscore WSTR, and Unicode text stream, that is DT underscore NText. So it will accept only DT underscore WSTR and DT underscore NText, as we have discussed in our last video as well. So in output of term lookup, we will get two extra columns, terms and frequency. So these two columns will be added in our output. So let's have a look of scenario. So this is our scenario. As we can see, we have a source table that contains the information of emails, and we have a reference table that contains the information of nouns and phrases. So as we can see, we have a OLEDB source. Here we have information of emails, and in our term lookup, we have a reference table that contains the information of nouns and phrases. And we don't want to load data in destination. We just want to check the data. That's why I have used multicast. So let's have a look of table. Go to on SSMS. Then we can see term lookup source table. Then we can execute our select statement. As we can see, we have the emails data. Now go to on our reference table. Let's execute the select statement for reference table. So as we can see, we are getting the courses, that is our nouns. So Python, SQL, SSAS, SSIS and SSRS. Go to on SSDT to implement the package. So here I gonna add one more package. So right click on this SSIS package, then new SSIS package. Then we need to rename this package. So this is for term lookup, so we can rename with term lookup. Then we have to use a data flow task, so we can drag and drop this data flow task. Then double click on this data flow task. So here we need to configure our source. So our source is SQL Server table, that's why we have to use OLEDB source. So now we need to double click on this OLEDB source. Then we need to select OLEDB connection manager. So I gonna click on new. So I have already made the connection, so click on OK. Here we need to select the table. So our table is term lookup source table. So this is our table. Now go to on columns. We are getting ID and mail description. So click on OK. So we have done our source. Now we need to configure our transformation. So our transformation is term lookup transformation. So we need to drag and drop this term lookup transformation. Then we need to connect with source. Now double click on this term lookup transformation. So as we can see our reference table. So here we need to select our reference table. So our reference table is term lookup reference table. Then go to on term lookup tab. So in this tab, we want to apply lookup with mail description from our input column and in our reference table with courses. So we can drag and drop. And in our output, we want all these columns. So we can select ID and mail description as well. Go to on advanced tab. Here we can see we can select the case sensitive option, but I am not going to use this option. So as we can see, it's going to reflect an warning. Rows sent to error output if the rows will be lost. So double click on this term lookup transformation. Then we need to click on configure error output. We can click on ignore failure. And here again we can select ignore failure, then apply and click on OK, then again OK. So we have done our transformation. Now we don't want to load data in any destination, so we just want to check the data. So we can use multicast, then connect with term lookup transformation. Here we can enable data viewer. So right click on this data pipeline, then enable data viewer. Now we can execute our package. So as we can see, this is ID and this is mail description. So we are getting the data, but we are getting two additional columns as I have discussed, term and frequency. So we can stop this package. Next is how term lookup works. So first is, if referent table contains singular form of word, then it would be considered both singular and plural form of data in our source as singular. As we can see here, source contains student and students. So we are getting two rows, and in our reference we have only student. So in our output we will get students two time, and it will reflect student and students. So go to on SSMS. So here in our case 1, I want to insert student in our reference table. I want to insert student and students in our lookup source table. So as we can see, two rows affected. Now go to on SSDT and execute our package. So click on start. So as we can see, student and students. So we are getting both record. Now we can stop this package. In our second, as we can see, if a reference table contain plural form of word, then this transformation considered singular and plural form separately at source. As we can see, source contains student and students, and in our reference we have students. So our output would student. Go to on SSMS, and this time I gonna update this lookup reference table with students. So one row affected. Now go to on SSDT. Now I need to execute this package one more time. So as we can see, we are getting students. Student and students both are treated separately. So we can stop this package. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.